Colin, what you got? Kelly?
16.
16 is 10 and 10. 10 and 1, 10. Sammy? 10 was 24. Peyton?
Number 9
should have been 0.12 as a decimal and 3/25 as a fraction. Frankie?
I didn't get number 9.
That's a great question. Answer first. Do you have Tyler, you have a question over an answer? No. Jordan, you have a question over an answer? No. Frankie asked about problem number 9, ladies and gentlemen. Let's take a gander at that one. Is this the one?
No.
Yeah. I can see it was changing already. Problem number 9 asks you to change 12% to a decimal and a fraction. Frankie, how do I change 12% first of all to a fraction? What do I make it as a fraction?
1/1.
Sorry, what's percent mean, sir? Percent means out of
100. Yeah.
Well, the fraction is 12/100, which needs to be reduced. But before you do that, how do you write 12/100 as a decimal? 0.12. Then just divide those out. Let's put those in the book. Those 4. 12 divided by 4 is 3. Okay. Number which one?
3.
2. Oh yeah, number 2. 6th grade, have we ever said tax and tip is always?
Multiplication.
Right, somebody said it. What? Multiplication?
Yeah.
Did you multiply, Eddie? Alright, what did you multiply together? So you want to know this. You want to know 7% of $6.80. Right?
Yeah.
So what did you change 7% to? We don't deal with percents. And you did?
Yeah.
And what answer did you get for that, by the way?
47.
Now, would that make sense? 7%, 7 out of 100, you're getting 40-some dollars. Did you move the decimal here? Let's do it. 7 times 0, sometimes 8 is what? 56, 42, 47. How many places do I move the decimal?
4.
Yep. 6th graders, everybody take a look up here because this is. How many of you got this part of the problem for that hard point? Please make sure you know this. In our money system for the 18th time here, we only go out to the hundredths place. Your answer to this is either going to be 47 cents. I will write it somewhere right here. 47 cents or 48 cents. We don't have a thousandth place in our money system. But we kind of do, but we don't have to use it. Because this number is 5 or greater, you have to add an extra penny onto that. So you get 48 cents. Now, unfortunately, Addie, Max, why don't you come sit next to Sam up here? Really? After all my warnings, Max, this is how you train
me.
Oh, Julia, sorry. You could take my name. I could put you next to Sam. I'm getting better at it, though. Now, why is 48 cents not the answer? Because I went through all that work, and that part of the problem is correct. Zach, why is that not the answer?
Because you have to add that to the form.
All right. Because that's only the tax. I still have to pay for my bill, because if I don't pay for my bill, they're going to throw me in jail. That's only the tax. So I add that. Addie, you with me? Now, here's the deal with that. You end up with $7.28, right? That's how much you have to pay, correct? And unfortunately, that's not the answer, Sam Sleezer. Why?
Because
Oh, I got some. Everything I have done so far is correct, but that is not the answer. And I'll still get it wrong because, Sam. Ping.
Because there's no second part.
Yeah, this is how much my bill was. This is how much I gave whoever it was that was taking the bill. It asked me how much money I get back in change. So to find that, Addie, I have to subtract the $10 from that. Which is that $2.72 part. So again, tomorrow when we take the test, make sure you know that it is a multiple step problem. Peyton?
Can you explain number one?
That is an outside chance. And like I told you last time, sixth grade, I will, because you're at the sixth grade part of math where things start getting a little harder, you can jot yourself down some notes, as I see some of you doing. Problem number one, sixth grade. Problem number one. Ask for the area of a parallelogram. What is the formula for the area of a parallelogram? Did you ask me this question?
Yeah.
Can you write that down?
Yeah.
Area equals base times height. Then what do we know about the base and the height? What's the thing you have to remember with base and height? I had this exact discussion with seventh grade today. Why doesn't it just say length times width? Why doesn't it just say multiply 5 times 6? Well, it doesn't say that because that wouldn't work. What is base and height, Victoria?
It has to form a right angle,
right.
So 6 and 4.
You are looking for that nice little square corner that the book would be nice to give. The two lines that form that are your base and the height. So the area should be 6 times 4. And that's how many squares that is. Does that help, Peyton?
Yeah.
Did I get the order you need there? Victoria?
Well, before you said area equals BH half,
that's
yeah,
for a triangle.
So I could.
That's for a triangle. I didn't say that for a parallelogram. If I did say that for a parallelogram, I'd get kicked out of the Mathematics Teachers Hall of Fame. Believe it or not. Rach?
I'm getting
out of
number 7.
Number 7? Yes, it's on this other page over here. Forty-five and 54. Did you get the prime factorization part right?
Yes.
So 45 you took, you did 5 times 9. Mm-hmm. And you got 3 times 3. You got 5. I'm sorry. You got 3 times 3 times 5. Yes?
Mm-hmm.
For the top. And then for 54, you broke that into 6 times 9. And 6 is 2 times 3, and 9 is 3 times 3. So you got 2 times 3 times 3 times 3.
Yeah.
And then you crossed off. This 3, this 3, this 3, that 3.
And I got 3 2/3 for an answer.
Yeah, but see, these crossed off, you're just left with a 5 on top, and 2 times 3 is a 6 on the bottom.
Oh,
there's
supposed to multiply those.
Right.
Okay.
Right. Did I get you there with that? Remultiply. Maybe you missed that part. Maybe that was when you were gone those days. Maxwell.
Is there going to be ever a time, like, say, if the 6 is on top and 5 is at the bottom, would you just have, or is that ever a time right now?
Could you get an improper fraction?
Yeah.
Yes, then you just have to make it a mixed
right.
number again. You'd have a 6 over 5.
Yeah.
It would only happen if, at this point, 54 was on top. The bigger number would have to be on top of the smaller number. Andrew?
Yeah.
For the number 7, the prime factorization, I still don't really get prime factorization.
What would you like me to run over there? You don't get how you make it a tree, you don't know how you break it down?
Yeah, I don't really know how I, like, break it down and then, like, 2 times 2 times 2 times 2.
Well, let's go. At what point? So around that 54, you don't get what, you don't get when you say what times what gives you 54? You understand what
time?
Like,
yeah.
So what do you get when 64? 54. What times what gives you 54?
6, 9.
This is all based on you, how well you know the multiplication things. Then you look at each one of those and you say, are those prime numbers? Is there a number that you can divide them by?
Yes.
And what is that?
3.
Well, 6 you can multiply 2 times 3 by to get 6, right? Mm-hmm. And 9 you can multiply 3 times 3 by, correct?
Yes.
Can you split any of these down any farther?
No.
You can't. Well, these are your numbers that you're left with. Whatever's at the bottom of your tree, that is the prime factorization of that. What part does that not? Where are we not? Whatever your bottom level is, that's the prime numbers that multiply to get you that.
What? I don't know. So the reducing thing on it, that's just finding the numbers.
Right, and then crossing them out when they have the same ones on top as the same ones on bottom. Are you talking about this?
Yes, still number 7.
Right, so this was 3 times 3 times 5 gave me 45, 2 times 3 times 2 times 3 gave me 54, and then if you find the same exact ones on top, as on bottom, you can cross them off. This didn't cross off, so that's when I got 6, I was still left with 5 on top. Great!
I'm getting
how I got number 18. See if you can get to the bottom of number 18. Rachel, did you make that proper? There you go. This would become 10 over 3, and this would become 6 over 5. Does that help? Rachel? Oh, I like that. Confidence notes to yourself. Take your time. It's like being your own cheerleader. Other ones? Great, one more.
19.
Problem number 19. Same thing, Rach. Did you make those improper? That would be the notes to myself before I do anything. See, this is going to be 5 over 1 divided by 5 over 3. Jacob Bauman, how do you divide by fractions? You? Flip and multiply by the second one. So, Rach, those would be 2 definite points to remind yourself. Any other ones, ladies and gentlemen?